Okay, welcome guys for the fourth game number 3 and maybe final game, or maybe the team Underdogs can step in and take one game for these guys. We everybody wants to see that. We want to see more DotA. Okay, so exactly the same bands again. Doom and Slaughter, Gyro and Konka. Okay. VS first pick again. Wow. For the team European Alphas again. Earthshaker first pick and Phoenix. Yeah, are they gonna play Phoenix right now? I don't know. Maybe they're tired from the Phoenix. Whoa. DJ, this is your year. Phantom's gonna come. It's gonna come soon. Don't worry, guys. What are these guys gonna pick? I mean, they. They removed the Earthshaker from Danish, so that's something. Maybe Shadow gonna play Earthshaker right now. Man, I really wish there will be another game. But if they win 3-0, yeah, they will just prove that they are the better team out of this tournament. Okay, Phoenix pick from the team Underdogs. Yeah, I don't know about this. I mean, I don't know who's gonna play what this here. Will Shadow will play the Earthshaker or the Phoenix here? I mean, either or, they are pretty good. They're pretty good Phoenix player and Earthshaker players. But I think Shadow plays. He likes to play his Earthshaker in the offlane. Juggernaut pick right now. Okay. That's a new one. That's
all right. I'm back. Sorry about that.
Hey, Phantom. Hey, they just team Underdogs. They first picked the Earthshaker here.
Interesting. Okay.
Yeah, they denied the Danish Earthshaker here, and they picked the VS and the Juggernaut here.
Jug. Interesting.
Yeah.
That's a good pick, though. I mean, Jug goes through so many stuns and disables with his Blade Fury, so it's a good pick. I'm assuming that'll be Master again, probably on him.
Yeah, for sure. The will they pick a Magnus here? Maybe. Pokban again. They don't want Vosje playing his Puck. His puck is a pretty solid puck.
Yeah.
He's so good out here.
Whichever ping he's on, it's pretty solid.
Yeah. Oh man.
I am surprised that there hasn't been more. I don't know. I always love a clock. I mean, he's so good at initiating and with his cogs and everything. We did a couple of games where it was clock, I think, and. Phoenix, and that was just such a nasty combo. You know, once you get someone stuck in cogs and you can just ray them, Oh, it's great. But,
yeah.
You know, he has to play an offlane, and there's not always a great matchup for him, so he's a bit situational. There's a lot of ways each draft can go. But you see, each team kind of has their comfort picks that they want to build the team around, like Venge on Fosjay's team and Phoenix on the other.
Yeah, maybe Shadow's Earthshaker as well. Okay, so look, I was thinking about something. Maybe Clock support 4. That's something as well, maybe.
Yeah.
I've seen Danish play it, so maybe that's still around. Respect ban from Ursa.
That's pretty funny. Yeah, poor Ursa wasn't his finest game last time, but
yep.
He really had no space, so
yeah, poor little.
It was a combination. He didn't have space, and he was a little overextending a little bit.
Yeah, that
Ursa does counter Jug pretty well, so that's a smart ban.
Yes, yes.
Now, I mean, they could easily go Nyx here, right? If you're Sentinel.
Yeah, sure. Because 1-on-1, the Nyx wins against the.
Yeah.
The.
I mean, he can just rage through his ultimate, or eat a creep, or go inside, and you know, I was surprised. Because the game before it was Nyx, and well, I guess the game didn't go that long, but that was one thing the RGC team did very well. The Nyx would infest an axe or something, you know, and do a cold.
Yeah.
And they could easily do that with Nyx and Earthshaker. You know, Earthshaker could initiate, and as soon as he pops his stun or ultimate, Nyx could jump out. So that would be a combination I'd look for.
Yeah,
this game.
Yeah, that's a pretty really strong combo right there. And even the Ursa pick was really strong for the Sentinel, but yeah, they're smartly denied it.
Yep.
Because I don't think they would play Nyx, that's why they didn't.
Well, I know Shadow and 1010 both can play Nyx if need be.
Yeah, for sure. Pretty much they were. Oh, Wisp!
Oh, ooh. No, they did it! We knew it was a matter of time.
in the game 3, dude. Oh, no.
Everyone, stay tuned. Smash that subscribe button for some top tier Wisp gameplay, this one.
Yep. Oh, man, so this.
You wonder how strong they're going to go with that. Like, obviously, Jug and Wisp could do something. They could also go a Tiny now. They could do a lot of different directions.
Yeah,
with
they
that.
Can go. They can do a lot. I mean, they can do maybe Bristol Bag or LC with the Wisp. They're so strong.
Yeah.
Yikes. You better pick something to counter that, to kill this Wisp really fast.
Yeah.
I normally, what I do, I mean, in pubs, it's to play Windrunner against a Wisp. Oh, look, they picked the Tiny here, but I don't think it will matter. They will try to do this with something else.
Yeah.
Yeah, look, Bristol back. Yeah, look at the Bristol back. I'm telling you. Bristol back plus. This plus the balls, plus the tether slow, plus his own slows, but and the heals from the Wisp, he can survive a long time.
They usually start it as dual lanes if they're going to do it the way they did before. So Wisp will kind of babysit the Bristle, and if you try to attack the Bristle or keep him off, then Wisp will just tether and then he'll spam goo and spines, and the damage racks up so fast.
Yeah.
And then as soon as Bristle has control of the lane, then he'll rotate around, so that's how they end up winning all three lanes sometimes. So,
yeah,
Sentinel's really gonna need to play this tight.
Yeah, we didn't talk about the Winter Wyvern. Winter Wyvern is pretty strong against Wisp too, because if you tether the Jug, if you tether the Jug and you ultimate the Wisp with the Winter Wyvern, yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, he can die pretty quickly.
And Jug ultimate is physical damage, right?
Yes.
So if Wyvern, once this gets to the team fight stage or even just gank, I mean, he should be able to Winter Embrace and protect whoever's getting, focused. So.
Yeah, for sure. And then, but the Bristol Bug is all physical damage too.
Yeah, so that is a good pick. Yeah, it's a good point you brought up.
Yeah.
They're gonna have to make sure to kill though the healing ward.
Oh my god! Yeah, the healing ward.
You don't want to bristle back regenerating health. Also, as he's charging at you, spamming spells.
Oh, a specter prick. Okay, so yeah, the wow. Look, the healing ward heals the bristle back. Yes, and he heals the ward heals the wisp too. And the wisp can regen more the
Bristleback.
Oh, which is gonna
that's gonna be a nasty combo if they can't take down that ward.
Yeah, yeah. Damn.
You're right, Bristle will be nearly unkillable.
Yeah, okay, so the Spectre pick here, Viper pick for the... Okay, maybe Tiny wants to go... Oh my goodness, this is gonna be rough for Tiny, dude. Tiny's gonna be mid against a Viper. Ay.
Man, just imagine getting chased by Bristle and Viper, both slowing you with goo and venom. That's not fun.
Yeah, that's not fun. I was about to say that. Oh, man. Okay, so Shadow is playing Phoenix now.
He's played that all three games, right?
Yeah. Who's playing? Smoker? Smoker, was he playing?
Smoker's playing Earthshaker.
Oh, Earthshaker, nice.
10-10's on a Spec. Pauline's on Tiny. Yep, and it looks like they're starting in dual lane, like I predicted. So Wisp is tethering with Bristle.
Yeah, I mean the Viper doesn't need help. He can pretty much own this Viper, this Tiny, by himself.
Yep. So Scourge should get this bot rune if they go on it, but I don't even know if they will.
Oh, they're going bottom. The Sentinel is gonna get it, right? Maybe.
I don't know. I think they're a little gun shy.
They're having second thoughts. Yeah. Oh my god, this is so good for the Sentinel. I mean, if they can get the first blood on the Wisp, but.
Yeah.
He's gonna go down. Yep, he's gonna go down. Nice kill. I mean, they got the room, but yep. He will pay for his life.
Yeah, that was good for them. Now Smoker's gonna have his work cut out for him, trying to farm against Jug and Avenge, because that stun and Blade Fury combo, ugh. Tiny versus Viper. I mean, gosh, their only chance is Sentinel needs to really control bottom lane.
Yeah,
if they don't, that means all three lanes they're pretty much lost.
Yeah, they have to. Or look at this, the item from the Wisp, 2 Mangos, 2 Fury Fires. Yeah, that's gonna be a lot of mana for. Look, I mean, I don't know if this is he's gonna survive. Okay, he broke the tether. I think he's in a lot of trouble right now.
Oh, but in the last second, Wisp is able to tether and.
Maybe he's still gonna go down. I mean, the Sun Ray is really strong against the Bristleback. That's one point they got in favor.
And looks like Smoker's making his way bottom lane. They're gonna have to do a switch, and he just decided to walk down. I don't think bot's gonna be much better for him, because it's still gonna be 2-on-1, and they can zone him out.
Yeah, for sure. I'm gonna give me 1 second.
Although, yeah, I was gonna say he could do a stun, but they should be able to tether him. Oh, nice stun. But he is able to get out.
Yeah, the heals are. I mean, actually, Danish is. He doesn't have any heals. Any salves or anything. Tangus. I've seen Wisp players. I mean, okay, they will try to get to kill this. The Spectre, will they get him before Bristleback dies? No, I think he's gonna live. No, one more auto attack from the bench is gonna get him. Okay, 3 versus. Okay, now this is now a tri lane now. Okay, the VS is gonna get the stun up on the Winter.
Jeez.
The Winter's gonna go down. Oh, never mind. The
magic damage is gonna go. Yep.
Okay, one more hit from the... okay, yeah, both are gonna go down now. They're gonna get the Spectre, the kills right here, maybe? One more hit?
Yep.
Okay.
But, you know, as we're all watching this... let's see.
Oh, whoa, one... Okay, that was a really nice TP. Now it's gonna go down!
Top, though.
Oh no, Bristleback gonna go down as well! Oh no, triple kill for... Okay, this is very, 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 very good for the Sentinel here.
Yeah, but Jug is free farming top, which is... That's an issue.
Yeah, that's an issue.
I mean, there's literally been no one top for the last 2 minutes. So.
Look at this huge creep wave. There's three magic, three range creeps. Okay, I need to fix the icons.
Yeah, no worries.
Who is this guy? Viper.
Man, a lot of kills early for Sentinel.
Okay, so I think we're ready.
We're only 4 minutes into the game.
And there's eight and kills.
Oh my gosh. So total creep stats. Sentinel as a whole team only has 12 creep kills. Vaz J by himself is 26 and 21.
Oh my god.
Jug is 24 and 5. I mean, so listen to that. Each one of them alone has more than their whole team combined. So
yeah.
even though Sent's getting a few kills bottom, mm-hmm. I mean...
They're not farming, yeah.
No, I'd say that the game's still definitely angling the way of Scourge.
Yeah, for sure. The Tenten has 10 last hits. So maybe he's a little bit better towards... No, never mind. Yeah, the Tiny is really having trouble here. He cannot stay. He cannot... go near the creeps here.
And now Jug's so farmed that if Earthshaker's anywhere near Jug, he can just phase boot, harass him, and I mean, he's gonna be level 6 any second.
Okay, Bristleback's gonna go down maybe? Okay. They will get them. Yeah, they will get him for sure. Everybody's gonna go down. V has one more hit.
Oh, and Spec. If Spec can get another triple.
Oh, one more hit for the kill. Okay. Okay, so they are winning this bottom lane, but they're dedicating four heroes in this.
Yep.
This is a quad lane, dude.
Yeah, like you said, they're doing what they need, and honestly, I guess if you had to choose one late game, I'd rather have Spec than Jug, but.
Mm-hmm. But the
you
thing
have
is,
to wonder
that
if it's gonna go that
yeah,
way at this rate.
If they can get there. Yeah, the Viper, I think he's gonna be huge because Viper is level 6 and Tiny is level 5. He's one level and a half better than the Tiny here.
Yeah.
Okay, I was about to say that the I've seen Wisp players to just don't get any items and just save for the bottle. Saving for the bottle. Imagine if that Bristleback would have like the bottle when he was diving on somebody, and he would definitely survive. Okay, they wanna go in the Wisp again. He's gonna go down, I think. One or two more hits. Yeah.
Nice spell gonna... by DC.
Yep. That's gonna follow him. The Bristleback's in trouble now. He's gonna go down. One more hit. Okay, he got the Tenten. He got the mega kill.
I think he must have procced his spines,
yeah.
You know, because I don't know how, that's just unlucky.
Yeah, man.
But yeah, Viper, I mean, gosh, Viper will probably have Pipe or whatever the heck Viper wants, he'll be able to get pretty soon. I mean, he's just not even challenged. Same with Jug.
Yeah, the Jug is level 7 right now. He will try to get, okay, Spectre is going to go TP top. I think he saw the TP. Maybe he will get the toss. He's gonna. Oh, I think you can toss him. Maybe. I will try.
If Spec can kill him, this is big.
Yeah, this is gonna go really, really
nice.
Well for the Spectre here. Okay, I think. I have to try it, but. Oh, and they get the deny on the tower.
Yeah, good play.
Okay, so I was about to say the I think you can toss the Juggernaut away from you. when he's on top of you in the ultimate. I think you can.
Really? I see. I'm not sure. But that would be a great play.
Yeah, I need to test that out, because I think you can in Dota 2. You can do it.
Now, and that was a good point you brought up about Wisp. You wonder. I think he might have gone, you know, bottle earlier, but he died right away at the lane. Remember when they went for rune? And he's already 0-4, so maybe he just hasn't had the gold, and now he's really going to be much less useful than he would have been. Uh-oh, we have a Lothard Viper.
Oh my god.
Uh-oh, just get a TP. Yep,
he got a
just
TP.
Get out of there, Spec. You got nothing to prove.
He's fine.
Good.
Now they will see it. Okay, bottom lane. The Titan is coming in. They will get the Bristol back.
Oh,
they won't even get
ult.
The...
Yep.
The Spectre is gonna go ult. Wisp is gonna go down. The Venge is gonna go down as well. The good rotation. I mean, five heroes on the bottom lane.
Wow.
But
well, look, I mean, look at the score. It's 15-4, but Scourge is still in a decent spot. It's crazy. If you're Sentinel, you've got to feel great right now. You're winning almost every engage.
Yeah. Look at the network. Look, the Scourge is ahead, 1K ahead, even though they
Well, that's the classic, you know, they're playing lanes, and, you know, you could say Jug should have come bot or something like that, but you'll live with Wisp dying a bunch, and even Venge, and, you know, because they're not going to be the ones to carry you home in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the supports are pretty rich. Look at the Ducario has Magic One, Arcane. Oh, they will see the Earthshaker here. Oh, never mind. That's his own teammate, sorry. Okay.
How do you feel about Viper rushing a Lothar's? Do you like that item?
Oh, wait. Something happened in the mid lane. The healing ward's gonna go. The Jug ultimate. Wow, that was so lucky, dude. Okay, he doesn't have mana for the spin. The Jug is gonna go down, maybe. One more hit. He will go down. Maybe if he would have micro the ward a little bit better, he would have lived. Because it was following the Viper there. Oh, never mind. Wisp is gonna. One more hit and he will die. Okay, so what I do with Jug, as soon as I cast my ward, I put it in control 2, so I can micro it instead of just trying to click on it.
That's smart.
That's what I do. But it takes a little bit of practice because it's. Yeah, because you take your hands out of the.
Yeah, but no, like, I mean, that's smart plays, though. Uh-oh. Viper's invisible again. If he can get the jump on...
Oh, my God. Maybe they can... Okay, never mind.
Nice save. The heals from the Ray and the Embrace.
Yeah.
Oh, brilliant.
Now the Spectre's gonna ult. They will get the Venge as well. Look at nice Fissure
Shadow,
block.
You gotta let Spec get that gold.
Oh, look. He tossed the Winter Wyvern to get the Winter's Curse on the Jug. I think it's gonna go down, maybe. The tether.
Whoa.
There was no tether for the Whisper. They are running over the Curse.
They should be able to get.
The tether is on cooldown for like another 5-6 seconds, maybe. Oh no, never mind. Okay, stun. I think they dive a little bit too much. Look at the heal support the Earthshaker here with the cold. Oh my god, the Wisp is like 1 HP, dude.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh, they just got Earthshaker.
Yeah, they got Earthshaker. They toss the Winter Wyvern again. Maybe he's gonna go down right now.
They gotta get out of there.
Yep. Go away, Shadow. He's gonna go down.
What was that?
Okay.
That was just a little bit too much.
Yeah,
but...
the Viper came in and did some clean duty, dude. Some generous duty. Oh my god. Okay, you said you asked me about this Lothar really quickly.
Yeah.
I don't know, because maybe if you can get some early kills, it's gonna be fine. But he did right now. He got a triple kill. Maybe he's gonna get his threats or not. Yeah, he's gonna get his threats and an Ogre Axe, I think. Yeah, an Ogre Axe for... I think this is gonna be Pike. No, Pike. Is that the
Silver Edge?
Oh yeah, maybe the Silver Edge.
Probably Silver Edge.
I was thinking about Dragonlance, but yeah, maybe the Silver. Yeah, pretty
Yeah,
early.
because Silver Edge cancels the spec passive,
Yep.
and I think also it would do Tiny if he wanted to
Okay,
cancel
so
his
okay,
skin.
yeah. Here's gonna. Oh, Jog is gonna get Winter Echoed and die. He's gonna go down. Discursed need to get the hell out of there. Oh my God,
Yeah.
he got the swap, but both are gonna go
Big
down.
plays.
Yeah,
Big
who got a
plays.
nice smoke right there. Look, okay, so I think the wisp gonna go is gonna be okay. Okay, so look at the these wards right here. They see each other, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, so the joke, okay, the smoke was here and the joke was here. He actually popped the smoke, but he wasn't fast enough so to get the dance. I mean, what's his
Yeah,
first? His
Blade
first,
Fury.
yeah, his Blade
I think
Fury.
that's what it's called. Yep,
And
no, that's a good point.
I mean, if it wasn't for that war for the Sentinel, they would have he would have just leave be okay.
Yeah.
But that was unfortunate. A lot of
Wow.
ascensions and wards.
Yeah, I guess Sent really had been slacking on the wards for a little bit of the game, so Wyvern's gonna get a full stack of both.
Okay, again, look, okay, they are rushing and killing everybody on the Scourge, but still, okay, never mind. The network is pretty even right now. It just updated. 1700 1000 every from both
The
sides.
later this game goes, though, the more it favors Sentinel, because Scourge, really their only late game is Jug. You know, Viper falls off later in the game. I mean, Wisp too. Bristle's okay, but I mean, compared to a spec,
Yeah.
Phoenix, I mean, even Earthshaker, I mean, they have so much here. And Tiny.
Yeah, Tiny can transition very well for to a semi carry.
Exactly. So, I mean, I'm surprised Sentinel was able to do so well kill-wise. So, if they can just hang on for maybe another 15 minutes and break even, I think the game would be theirs.
Yeah, if you are Scourge, what would you do to try
Well,
to?
I would force some, you'd say force some team fights, but I would probably do like 3 and 2 pushes, like try to do Jug and maybe Wisp or something in top, and then the other all three of you bot, try to just, you gotta take spec out of farming. You know, if he's just doing really well now and their team fight is great. But yeah, I don't know. Or you could just try to straight up force a five man, but I don't think that's to Scourge's advantage right now.
Yeah, I mean they have to do something because they cannot just farm away. Okay, so the Brewster bag has a pretty good stack here, like a 3 stacks maybe or 2 stacks.
I think it was 3 when he started.
Yeah, he's gonna be a little bit really happy with that stack. Okay, the Viper is gonna get Lothar's in. He won't. I mean, even though if he can find this guy, okay, maybe he can. Yeah, maybe he can die. He's alone here.
If I was Wyvern, I would have. He was right there. I would have put the ward up, but. Oh, and Viper catches Tiny behind the tower.
Yeah. On the bottom lane, Echo's gonna go down for the Wisp. Wisp is the hate is real, you know?
Yeah. You've got to think Spec's going Radiance next, right? I mean, he's got his phase, he has an urn, and he's gotten good kills. That has to be the play, right?
Actually, he went for Yasha. Yeah, that's his
Oh.
Yasha, I think.
Wow.
Maybe he wants
Well.
to. Maybe he wants to just get a Manta Defusal and try to win like a mid game because you're already winning some high fights.
Yeah. And I mean, I think the best thing about Radiance is it cancels, you know, Blink, you
Yeah.
know, but they don't have any heroes that are really Blink initiators, you know, like they don't have Earthshaker on Scourge, they don't have Enigma, so maybe Radiance isn't as useful this game.
Yeah, the Radiance, the good thing about Radiance as well is that you can speed rocket your farm.
Yeah.
That's one advantage. But also the Yasha makes you walk a lot faster with this phase boost as well. So Yikes. Okay, so the network is again up for the scourge.
Yeah, that's crazy, isn't it? You look at the scoreboard and
yeah,
it doesn't feel like it, but I mean, they only have one, Sentinel only has one tower down.
Yes. Okay, yeah, they are 5k away. Oh, never mind, 2k. Oh, here they just uploaded. Okay, I think gonna go. They want to kill this Spectre. They will get him. Maybe. Oh, never mind. The jug was here alone. He tipped to the top lane. That's pretty smart. Don't TP home if you're
Phoenix rushing. It looks like Crimson this game.
Yeah, that's pipe. Pretty.
No, yes. No real need for pipe this game. So yep. That makes sense.
Yeah, pretty smart. Yeah, this jug needs a lot of damage so he can just go through that Crimson. And the bottom lane, they're gonna try to get some of these towers. Oh, blink on Tiny. Can he stun him? Yeah, he can stun him, but no detection. They're gonna go on Tiny right now. The Spectre ultimate is gonna come on. This the whip is gonna go down. The bench is gonna go down.
Wow.
Oh my goodness. Look at this echo on. This is.
That's pretty much.
Wow.
I'd be shocked if Sentinel loses at this point now. I mean, that's another triple kill for Spec.
Yeah. I mean, maybe he can now go for the radiance. Maybe. He got a lot of gold right there.
Yeah.
2100, 2200. Damn.
Yeah, that was the great initiation, great fight. And I mean, that Wyvern and Ray combo, I mean, you can be at critical damage, and by the time you come out of that, you're already back to over, you know, half HP. It's huge. Mm-hmm. And they don't have real magic damage. Oh, what is this now?
Oh,
poor Wisp trying to make a play, but just not able. Yeah. What was I gonna say? They only really have magic damage through Venge's stun. I mean, that's really the only one. So once he's in, they have the Wintern Embrace. They can't touch him.
Yep. Yeah, this Winter Weaver pick is working so good against this all of this physical damage.
Yeah.
Man, in combination with the Ray from Phoenix, he's just very tanky. Okay, so the Spectre's gonna get. He got his Manta now.
Yeah, so I guess he is still. He might not even do Radiance at all, mm-hmm. But yeah, he's got a nice Manta before 20 minutes.
Yeah, Manta Diffusal is so powerful. If you can get it before 25 minutes or something, it's really, really strong. You can melt everybody. Everybody supports and any cores. Maybe except for Viper, but Viper is really tanky. And okay, he got his Silver Edge. Yep.
The more this game goes on, though, I really feel like that Silver Edge rush was not the play. I mean, they really could have used a pipe. I mean, think of all the magic damage with Wyvern, with Earthshaker, that's the plan, I guess. Well, it looks like Bristle's gonna go that, but Viper could have had it way sooner.
Yeah, for sure. The Silver Edge is like what, 5.5. Gold?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty strong. I mean, pretty expensive.
Yeah, and I mean, I get the logic behind it. He was going that to counter a lot of their good passes, but man, it's not worked out that way.
Yeah, I think they are just missing an initiator.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Because this curse has like two or three initiators. The Spectre kick. Okay, they initiate when the bench. With the bench, he will.
He's down.
Yeah, he's gonna go down.
And look, they're going for Spec top, so they're not even there. So is he gonna get out in time?
Yeah.
Run, Spec.
I think he can just kill this guy.
Oh wow!
The Cripple is gonna tank the. Can he get the Spectre kill? I mean, oh my.
Oh, he was so close, but they end up. They're gonna take.
Oh, in the mid lane.
Oh, what's happening?
The Bristol is in a little bit of trouble, maybe. The egg is gonna go off. I don't think that was a good. Oh my god, he missed the stun! The avalanche! Oh no! Okay, he will die.
So even though Spec died top, he did get the tower, and I mean, that means there were two less people mid, so it was still a net positive for him.
Yeah, and they still got the kill on the Bristol back, I don't know.
Shadow's gotta get out of here.
Oh no, he's in trouble. Can they see him?
Why is he doing that?
They see him now with that.
Oh man. You gotta go back. I don't know why he raid. They definitely knew where he was then and it only drained his health, but
yeah. Oh, where are they going? They're going bottom lane. They're gonna kill the Winter Warrior here, I think. Yeah, there will be enough damage here. Yeah, three hits.
Yeah.
You think this is a BKB for Viper or Pyke? I mean, Dragonlance. I think BKB.
Probably BKB would be my guess.
Yeah, the BKB is... They have a lot of...
He's got enough HP and everything right now. I don't think he needs to worry about, you know, distance. But yeah, the spec hitting the dagger because they have full vision there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see the new items. Pipe is up for the Bristol back. Four staff up for the bench. Wisp, he doesn't have his mechanism yet.
No, I think Scourge is smart though to be forcing the fights now because they've got to somehow catch them off guard, get a few kills, because if this game, yeah, if it keeps going the way it is, I don't think they win. Specs only getting stronger. I mean, now Tiny has Lothar and Blink, Earthshaker has Blink, so they're really starting to get their combos now.
Yep. And the Jugger now, he got, okay, Bristol, like, so they initiate on the bench. He will live with that. Okay, will they have the BKB is popped. He's gonna go down anyway. He's 1v5 right here. He's, oh my god, the Juggernaut was there.
But here comes Jug.
Yeah, the Juggernaut with the Wisp, they're gonna go down as well. They will not get the Earthshaker here. He's just waiting. He has a Fissure. One more hit. Oh my god,
Dude,
a smoker.
We got us a rampage.
We got a rampage right here.
I think that's the first rampage of the tourney finals, right?
Yeah, the semifinals. No.
Of the finals, of these
two
games,
finals.
Right?
Yeah.
That was a nice play because I think Jug would have hit him, but he waited for the stun and then just got that one last shot in. So big
play
there.
Yeah, and I saw Smoker cancel his Fissure because the Fissure would have hit. He was still he was still spinning, and that, oh man, that was such a good play by our Smoker there.
Yep.
Blinking
for
in,
sure.
Get the totem and get the kill. He tried to steal it or not. that's a pretty good rampage right there.
But yeah, they just missed killing Venge, because they tried to do the combo right away, and Venge escaped with like 50 HP, and then Smoker did catch him.
Tenten with the ultimate got him.
Oh, okay.
Oh, one more hit, and they will kill him. He would have maybe had enough time to stun him, but.
What do you think next for Spec? Diffusal, Heart. It's a lot of things. Comes Viper.
Okay, he's fine. They have a center. They will see him. Please. Oh, that was so close.
Oh, and they missed him.
Oh, the dust as well. They see him, but they didn't catch him.
Yeah, Tiny should have either stunned or tossed him back, but just out of range.
For the Spectre, he has 4.5k. Maybe he's just going hard. Maybe, because if he can survive the Omni Slash, and I don't know if he can survive the burst. It's so, I mean, he can he survived
yeah.
for so long.
No, you're right. Then he doesn't have to worry about anything in the team fight. Uh oh, Viper's coming.
Oh, he has a haste. Okay, then he will just TP out. Maybe he can get it still. Oh no, one or two.
Oh!
Okay. Will he go down in the fountain? Oh my god.
Whew, that was close.
Yeah.
He got down to like 30 HP, but just started regenning enough.
Okay, the Crimson Guard on the Phoenix now.
And now an ultimate, so he might just be going, looks like he's going Skatey.
Okay. Yeah, that's he will be really, really tanky.
That still gives him tank, without heart. Mm-hmm. So that's not a bad one. It gives him a slow too on his attacks.
Yep. That's a that's a pretty nice item for him if he can get him. I mean, he will get him in like 2 or 3 minutes.
Yep.
The jug has I clicked him before, where is it?
Okay. He just has Django and Sangha Yasha, so even though he had pretty much free farm the first 7-8 minutes, he's falling off a lot now.
Who's going Badware here? Oh, the Bristlebat's going Badware. He has a Claymore, I think, on the on the courier for the jug. Maybe. I don't know what that is. Maybe another Lotters?
Maybe, but for who?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't. Or someone would be. I don't think anyone on their team really would go. Oh, could be a Jug Battle Fury,
oh,
maybe.
In the mid lane, they will get the Winter Wire. Maybe. There's a lot of damage. The Spectre Art comes up. The Winter's gonna go down before actually doing does something here. The Viper gets touched back, and he will survive because of that. Maybe, never mind, the Spectre will get him. The Egg on 2 here, they will get the Whips as well.
Egg survives, and Tiny's going to be able to toss back.
He doesn't... Oh, what's happening? Top! Look at Top! I think they tried to get the rocks right here, but he is going to be fine. He's going to go TP out. That's nice. Okay, they get the Bristol Bat.
Wow.
Here.
So that's a 4-for-1 trade.
Yes.
Get the bot tower, but he didn't get anything in the base, so they'll live with that. Might be a good time to grab a quick Roche if I was Sentinel.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, so no, you're right. That was a Lothar's for Jug.
Yeah, I don't know.
I guess they're going for escape, but I don't know. It only takes one dust to counter both of you guys then.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Maybe he's trying to get a Silverish as well for the Spectre.
Yeah.
Yep, Scotty is down for 10-10 here in the Spectre. Now the Tiny is getting his axe after Lothar's. He's halfway there.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, barring some colossal throw, Sentinel really has control of this game. So they should be able to just control it, push the lanes out, and here we got smoke.
Yep, they're
smoke coming. And that's smart by Scourge.
Yeah, try to.
Everything's going the other team's direction, so try to catch them off guard.
Yeah, I don't know if you want to initiate on the Spectre.
No,
maybe.
Spec.
No, they will get the Manta off. He will dispel. Oh my goodness. The big Winter Wyvern on everybody. The Echo Slam on everybody as well. The Wisp cannot take. He's stuck here.
That'll do it, I think.
Yep.
That was one last stand. And that, honestly, it was a good call by Scourge. Just didn't work out.
Yeah, trying to get something, but the Spectre is gonna be in the front.
Oh, I forgot Bristle's still here.
Oh, he's still there.
I didn't even notice him. But he's gonna go down.
He's gonna know that. Yep.
He did get Wyvern before he went down, though.
Yeah, triple kill and the GG comes up. I think they're gonna. Yep, the players GG out. Nice.
All right.
Wow, what a game.
That was a good game. That was well played. And.
Oh wow! Okay,
that was a lot of fun.
We will have a game 4. Can they come back from the team to KDU? Can they come back though? That's the question. I hope they will.
Yep, we'll be back soon, guys, for game 4.
Game number 4. See you guys.
All right.